going to talk about logistics and data, and I'm going to show you how data will change logistics jobs, and especially for inventory managers. So basically, logistics is a cost center for all companies that sell products, which means that for our logistics services, the only way to grow is to reduce costs. And as you can imagine, data science can help reduce these costs while maintaining a high customer satisfaction. Indeed, there is a balance to be found between the stored value and the service rate. Since fewer parts in stock, well, it costs less, but inevitably implies a decrease in the service rate. So in the example I'm going to present today, our goal was to reduce storage costs for maintenance parts for an industrial company. The method we used was first make a monthly prediction of demand, and here demand is the stock consumption for each piece, and then make a recommendation of inventory level. So the first question we asked was, what does stock consumption look like for maintenance parts for this company? And as you can see, maintenance parts have a very sporadic consumption type, which means that parts are consumed at very long and irregular intervals. As you may know, this is very hard to predict. So given this particular type of stock consumption, we found that the cross-ton model is the most appropriate. You can find it easily in literature for intermittent demand forecasting. So very briefly, how this model works. It does two independent predictions. One here, S, for the value of each stock consumption, and another one here, I, for the interval between two consecutive stock consumptions. And the prediction of the model is an arbitration between the last prediction and the most recent observation. And thanks to this exponential smoothing principle, historical data receive variable weights according to their age in time. And these weights are represented in the model with two smoothing parameters. Then the business knowledge makes it possible to add rules for parts that cannot be modeled because they do not have enough historical data. So you end up with a flowchart with a specific rule for each category of items. So for example, for a very expensive item, which is not sensitive and which is rarely consumed, it might be better not to keep stock because being able to answer to all orders in this category would explode the capital tied up. Then the custom algorithm generates a number of models that test different combinations of our two smoothing parameters. And the calculated models are evaluated against two KPIs defined initially, here service rate and stored value. And for example, you'll get a graphic like this, where one point represents one model. So I'm sure objectively you all think that this one is the best model regarding the two KPIs, but maybe at first the inventory manager might want to choose this one to build trust with warehouse teams. Because at the end of the day, the best model is not the one that fits from a mathematical point of view, it's the one that fits a business reality. So to conclude, in this case, the AI is not self-supporting because as we saw after the cross-ton modelization, there was an adaptation to a business context, and the inventory manager needs to analyze the results, choose the best model, and then implement it within the whole supply chain. So tomorrow, inventory managers will have to work with AI under the form of a decision support tool and not being replaced by AI. Thank you.